Welcome to the video. In the previous video, we studied the sedimentation, principle of sedimentation, types of settling that occurred in the sedimentation process. Now, in this video, we will be discussing the design of sedimentation tank. The contents are types of sedimentation tank and design parameters of the sedimentation tank. So let us start with the types of sedimentation tank. Depending upon the various factors, sedimentation tank are classified as follows. First, based on the method of operations. First, in that fill and draw type tank and the continuous flow type tank. Based on the shape, the tanks are classified as a circular tank, rectangular tank and hopper bottom type tank. And based on the location, the sedimentation tank are classified as a primary tank and the secondary tank. So let us discuss each and every type in detail. First of all, based on the process, it is a fill and draw type sedimentation tank. If you see the figure, it is a rectangular sedimentation tank. In this, first of all, the entire sedimentation tank or the tank is filled up with the wastewater. Then the sufficient detention time is provided so that the sedimentation or the suspended particles present in the wastewater start settling due to reduction in the velocity. So let us discuss in detail. In case of fill and draw type sedimentation tank, water from inlet is stored for some time. The time may be 24 hours. It can, in that time, the suspended particles are settled at the bottom of the tank. After 24 hours, the water is discharged through the outlet. Usually, as shown in the figure, the inlet is provided at the top of the tank, whereas the outlet is provided at the bottom of the tank, after providing sufficient depth for the deposition of the silt or the suspended particles. Then settled particles are removed. This removal action requires 6 to 12 hours. So one complete action of sedimentation requires 30 to 40 hours in case of fill and draw type of sedimentation tank. So in this, 6 to 12 hours are required for the removal of all settled sludge. And again, 24 hours for the sedimentation. So entire cycle is of 30 to 40 hours. So in this case, if the fill and draw type sedimentation tanks are provided in the wastewater treatment plant, we have to make arrangement of 3 to 4 such type of tanks so that the entire cycle will get continuously operated. Then continuous flow type sedimentation tank. On the contrary, here the flow, as the name suggests, the flow is continuous one. In this case, water is not allowed to rest as in the fill and draw type sedimentation tank. Flow allows always takes place but with a very small velocity. During this flow, the suspended particles are settled at the bottom of the tank. The flow may be either in the horizontal direction or vertical direction. As shown in the figure, the baffles are provided. These baffles are responsible for the reduction in the velocity. As the velocity reduces, the sufficient sedimentation or the settling can be achieved, and thereby the sedimentation is achieved and the settled sludge is taken out and discharged from the tank. So here the main parameter is the flow always takes place, means it is a continuous flow. Based on the shape of the tanks, it is classified as a circular, rectangular and the hopper type. So let us discuss the circular tank first. In the circular tank, the wastewater enters at the center. The flow radially outward to periphery. In such tank, scraper shoe are mounted on the rotating frame and sludge is collected in the sludge sump located at the center. The vertical flow circular tank are usually in the form of small diameter circular tank with deep conical hopper. The diameter of the tank may vary from 7.5 to 9 meter. They are constructed partly below the ground and partly above the ground. The wastewater, after passing through the screen, enters the tank from near the bottom, rises upward through the sludge blanket, get clarified, and then escapes through a effluent trough located along the periphery. The tank is so designed that upward velocity of the flow is less than settling velocity of the smallest particle to be removed. Thus, the wastewater can be passed with relatively higher velocity. Also, shorter detention time are required, resulting in small volumes. As shown in the figure, if we see, the inlet is provided at the bottom at the center, from where the wastewater enters. It rises up and it enters in the sedimentation tank at the center, and then the flow and the wastewater flows radially outward during entire action. During their travel, this velocity get reduced and the sedimentation occurs. Sedimentation, all the settled sludge will start settling on the sloping bottom, where the scraper arrangement is provided to scrap and for removal of the sludge. Whereas the cleared water or the treated water enters into the troughs or the outlet provided at the top of the circular tank, from where it is discharged and the accumulated sludge is taken out from the bottom, as you can see in the bottom where the outlet for the sludge is provided. Then hopper bottom type sedimentation tank. In case of hopper bottom tank, a deflector box is located at the top, which deflects the influent coming from the center pipe to downward. Sludge is collected at the bottom and it is disposed through the sludge pump. So you can see here the inlet is provided. The inlet pipe attached to the center pipe, from where the wastewater enters in the hopper bottom. Due to the action, the sludge present or the suspended particle present in the wastewater starts settling in the bottom, and the clear water rises at the top, and they are taken from the effluent channel, which are provided at the top on the periphery of the hopper tank. Whereas the one sludge pipe is provided, the sludge, settled sludge, is pumped through that pipe and taken out where in the sludge sump. Now, based on the location, the tank, sedimentation tank, is classified as a primary and secondary sedimentation tank. If suppose the sedimentation tank is provided in the primary treatment, it is called as a primary sedimentation tank. And if the sedimentation tank is provided in the secondary treatment, then it is called as a secondary sedimentation tank. But what is the significance and which type of action is taking place, that we will discuss in this particular topic. Primary sedimentation tank is a normal sedimentation tank in which water and wastewater is stored at a rest for some time, and sludge collected at the bottom and oily matter collected at the top are removed. After primary sedimentation process, the wastewater is sent to the biological treatment. So here in the primary sedimentation tank, only the suspended particles and oily matter are removed. Here the physical separation is carried out. Whereas in the secondary sedimentation tank, after the primary sedimentation tank, the wastewater coming in the secondary sedimentation tank, there the biological treatments are occurred. After biological treatment, activated sludge process, the wastewater enters the secondary sedimentation tank in which the suspended particle contain microbes are removed and are reflected are returned towards the aerobic filter to maintain the high microbe concentration in the aerobic filter. So in the primary sedimentation tank, the water the operation just removes the suspended particle, whereas the suspended particle with the organic matter are decomposed and removed in the secondary sedimentation tank by biological treatment or called as a activated sludge process. This is the actual mechanism by which the settling is occurred. Consider the particle of diameter d which is just removed with the settling velocity vs. So if you see the figure, the vs is shown in the downward direction, so it denotes or it indicates the settling velocity. The size of the basin is l into b into h. In that case, the vs is equal to h by t. That is equal to, we can write the t as h divided by v by q. Further elaboration will be h into q divided by l into b into h, which will give you the q divided by l into b, which is nothing but the q divided by area a, that is surface area. So we can see that the velocity is a directly proportional to flow and indirectly proportional to the and inversely proportional to the surface area of the tank, where the t is the retention time, which is given by v by q, a is the surface area of the basin, that is l into b, vs is the settling velocity of the particle, the volume of the water flowing in the unit time per unit surface area of the settling basin is known as surface overflow rate. It is also called as a overflow rate. It is very simple that when the volume which is measured per cubic per square meter, so it is called as a overflow rate. Overflow rate is given by flow rate meter per second divided by settling surface area in the meter square. Detention time. This is the theoretical time that the water is detained in a settling basin. It is evaluated as the volume of the tank divided by the rate of flow and is denoted by the d is equal to v by q. So to calculate the detention time, the formula is v by q. Thus it is that time which would required by the flow of vortex to fill the tank if there were no overflow or outflow. Detention time t for the rectangular tank is volume of tank v, that is rate of flow, q, and the detention time for the circular tank, where d is equal to diameter of the tank, h is the vertical depth of the wall or the side depth, and depth b and l is equal to width and length of the rectangular tank respectively. Other design parameters that need to be considered in the design of sedimentation tanks are detention period. For plain sedimentation, 3 to 4 hours, and for coagulated sedimentation, 2 to 2.5 hours. So, as compared to the coagulated sedimentation, the plain sedimentation required much more time, whereas in the coagulation sedimentation tank, the detention time get reduced. Longer detention period beyond 4 hours may affect the performance due to the settling in the septic condition. If in case the detention extend beyond the 4 hours, it may result in the putrefaction of the organic matter or the suspended organic matter present in the suspended solid. So it will lead to the septic condition, which is not a desirable. Horizontal velocity of the flow should not be greater than 30 centimeter per minute. So accordingly you can convert it into meter per second for the horizontal flow. Then tank dimension, depth should be between 2.5 to 5 meter, usually the 3 meter is adopted. Effective depth, that is depth excluding the bottom sludge zone, will range in between 2.4 to 3.6 meter. So here we have to keep in mind that we have to provide such the depth, that depth will include the bottom sludge zone also, or the sufficient depth should be provided for the settlement or for accumulation of the sludge, and the rest of the depth or remaining depth for the clear water. So by considering that, the effective depth is calculated. Length should be 90 meter, width 30 meter, whereas length to width ratio should be between 1.5 to 7.5 and the length to depth ratio should be between 5 to 25. Then for the circular sedimentation tank, diameter should not be greater than 60 meter. Generally, the 20 to 40 meter diameter is adopted, whereas water depth should be 2 meter and the floor slope should be 2.5 to 10%, where wear loading, that is flow divided by length of wear, should not be greater than should be less than 100 meter cube per day per meter for primary settling tank, and it should be less than 150 meter cube per day per meter of secondary settling tank. Whereas surface overflow rate for the plain sedimentation should be between 12,000 to 18,000 liter per day per meter square of tank area. For thoroughly flocculated water, it should be between 24,000 to 30,000 liter per day per meter square of tank area. Slope should be, for this rectangular, it is 1% toward the inlet, and for circular it is 8%. And the efficiency is given, nu is given by 1 minus in bracket 1 plus n Vs divided by Q by A bracket close raised to minus 1 by n. These are the design steps that we need to follow while solving the numericals based on the design of sedimentation tank. First step, compute the critical velocity, settling velocity, for the smallest size particle to be removed. Second step, equate the critical velocity to the overflow rate, incorporating the basin efficiency, and compute the surface area. Third step, fix the dimension L and width or diameter, and select the appropriate depth and detention time. So by using the design parameter, you can choose any depth, length, width and diameter, and by that you can calculate the suitable depth and detention period also. Step 4, check for the adequacy of the design criteria like overflow rate, depth, detention time, solid loading rate, wear loading and score velocity, etc. So after calculating all this, after fixing the dimension, you can check your calculation for all these criteria. Then step 5. Design inlet and outlet and sludge withdrawal arrangement. These are some design recommendation or the parameters that we need to follow for the different types of settling. If the primary settling is there, overflow rate should be between, for the average it should be 25 to 30, and for the peak it should be 50 to 60, and depth should be between 3 to 3.5. So as the case changes or as the type of settling changes, the overflow rate in meter cube per day per meter square for average and for peak, and accordingly the depth varies. So you have to refer these parameters while designing the sedimentation tank as the case may be. In this video, we have discussed about the different types of the sedimentation tank and the design of sedimentation tank, and the recommendations for the design sedimentation tank for the different condition. The numerical based on this design of sedimentation tank are available in the PDF 2.8. So kindly go through, watch it and solve the numericals. Thank you for watching. Happy learning.